Everybody, I'm just gonna wait for Amy to come and then we'll get started on today's stream. So, as you can tell by what I'm wearing and what I'm sitting on, we are doing a yoga video today. As you guys wanted us to do on our poll, on my poll I put out, you guys wanted to see me and Amy do some yoga today, so we're gonna do it. We're gonna be following a video. I am sharing the screen. Okay, there's Amy. I'm gonna mute the video. Okay. Just gotta wait. Let's bring Amy in. I'm itchy. Okay. It doesn't look like our internet's very working today.
Many unbearable hours later.
Hello.
There.
Hi.
A little bright. It's gonna turn this around.
Okay, ready to get started, Amy? I am gonna put this a little bit to the back.
Trying to make sure you can see me properly.
I'm gonna use my camera, then we can get started on the video today.
Gonna try something. No, you can't see me. Oh, I got it. I'm going to put you right here.
There you go.
There. All right. Oh, I'm just going to put this back on. Oops. Laundry basket. All right, yep.
Okay, ready to get started?
Yes, here we go.
Okay, so the yoga we're doing is to feel your best. That's what it's called. And so, because everyone needs to feel their best, so meaning that why not do some relaxing, yet somewhat challenging yoga today, as you guys all requested. So, let's get to it. I'll play the video. Okay, the video's playing. Is it working for you, Amy?
No, I'm not seeing it.
Should I send you a link and then we can watch at the same time?
Sure, you should do that because it's not working.
Okay. Sorry, guys. Technical difficulties.
This will just take a minute.
5 minutes later.
Yes.
In case you're wondering about the background, this is my parents' room because my sister's in the living room, so I'm just
okay, so because the screen sharing isn't working, I'm just going to hang up the call.
Okay.
And then I'll just send you a link, and then we can work on it that way.
Yep, we'll be right back, guys. Take a look at difficulties.
Yeah. We're having a little bit of technical difficulties, but we're working on it.
A few moments later.
Okay, I sent you the link.
Yeah, I see it.
You got it? All right. Go to 52 seconds.
Oh, hold on.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting and they had to hire a new one.
52.
Okay, ready?
All right, now we can
press play in 3, 2, 1, now.
Here we go. Make sure
your best. So when you've found your seat, sit up nice and tall, bringing your attention and your awareness to the line that runs from your crown to the base of the spine of your tail.
It's crooked.
And just notice where you are quite literally today. Like, are you kind of shifting forward? Is it really hard to sit up tall? Are you starting to notice the benefits of your daily practice kind of start to pay off here? Wink, wink. So just notice. I know when I first started practicing, it's hard for me to talk with my eyes closed, that it was really difficult for me to sit up tall in meditation. Now I feel much more at ease here. So wherever you are, just lean in, notice. And then let's all close the eyes if you haven't already. Just soften through your fingertips wherever you are. And we're going to inhale, take a deep breath in. Feel all four sides of the torso with air, really dropping that breath into your belly. And then exhale, let it out through the mouth as you relax your shoulders. Twice more, just like that. A little deeper, a little longer with the breath each time. Here we go, big inhale, fill up. Nothing fancy. Exhale, empty it out. And one more time, big inhale. Breath travels down as you breathe in. And then we flip the direction of the breath. It comes up as we exhale out through the mouth. Beautiful. Bring the palms together at your heart. Bring your head toward your heart, your chin towards your chest. Now with the eyes closed, set a little intention here, something that's going to help you feel your best. You can maybe complete the sentence, I choose. Go blank. And start to breathe deep as you feel this deep stretch in the back of the neck and the traps, the upper back body. Lower body is nice and heavy. Excellent. If you've landed on something, go ahead and repeat it. Consider it already done. Imagine it already so. As you quietly repeat your intention, just trust that whatever came up, it's the right thing. Okay, and then slowly let's release. We'll bring the head back up, head over heart, heart over pelvis. If you're not in a cross-legged seat, you can still do this next little ditty. Just catch up with us when you need to, or go ahead and transition in now. All right, left hand's going to reach all the way up towards the sky. And then exhale, bring it all the way down. Inhale, right fingertips reach all the way up towards the sky. Exhale, bring it all the way down. Now both arms, fingertips are going to go behind the ears as you reach all the way up. Big breath in, stretching through all four sides of the torso, the front, the back, side to side, reach, reach, reach. And then on your exhale, you're going to send your right hand to your left knee for a twist, seated twist here. Breathing down into the belly. Again, that directional breath as you breathe in. And then think of the breath coming up and out through the nose as you exhale. Inhale to lift and lengthen, grow a little bit taller in the spine. Exhale to twist just a little deeper, maybe send your gaze gently past your left shoulder. And for one more cycle of breath here, just notice where you might be gripping or holding in the toes or in the jaw or in your hands, and see if you can soften, relax any tension. And we'll come all the way back to center, head over heart, heart over pelvis. Now this time with the right arm, we're syncing up the breath to the movement and the movement to the breath. Inhale as you reach it up. Exhale as you bring it down with control. Inhale as you reach it up. Catch something. Exhale as you bring it down with control. Now both arms, fingertips are going to go behind the ears. Engage through your core, your center. Draw the navel in and up as you reach the fingertips all the way up towards the sky. Big breath, big stretch. And then exhale, nice easy twist to your right. So left hand comes to the right knee, right fingertips behind. And we want to try to maintain that head over heart here. So if you're collapsing back here, let's see if we can work in time to bring the head over the heart, heart over the center. And if you feel like that's impossible, you might sit up on a blanket or a towel. Lift the hips up. Okay, we're breathing here. Keep the chest lifting. Notice where you might be gripping or holding. See if you can soften with every exhale and sit up a little taller with every inhale. Again, find that directional breath as you breathe down. Belly expands. Relax the shoulders as you breathe out. Great, take one more cycle of breath here. Then together we'll inhale in, sit up nice and tall, and exhale, come all the way back to center. Awesome, we're gonna take our fingertips forward and continue this forward motion all the way to all fours. So find your tabletop position. Try to be meticulous right away. Wrists underneath the shoulders, so you're stacking the bones. Knees right underneath the hip points, so not too wide, not too narrow. And then spread your fingers super wide like starfish. Upper arm bones rotate out externally away from your chest, and the elbow creases shine forward. Then press firmly into the tops of the feet here. Inhale in, exhale, claw through the fingertips. Start to hug the lower ribs up and in here. Again, still pressing into the tops of the feet. Beautiful, neck is nice and long. Gaze is straight down. So we have this nice, engaged, active tabletop position. We're gonna put it to the test by curling the toes under, inhaling in and exhaling, lifting the knees, letting them hover. You'll start to feel your low belly turn on, upper arm bones still rotating out. We're breathing here. We're starting to find that shake, that prana, that sensation that reminds us, oh, we are alive and well. We're here for 3, 2, knees kiss the earth on the 1. Uncurl the toes, drop the belly, open the chest. Cow pose, breathe in. Soften your gaze or close your eyes. Really feel what's going on in the spine today. Final call. And then here we go. Exhale, chin to chest, same thing. Paying attention to the sensation. All right, and keep it forward with your breath. Inhale, drop the belly. Exhale, round through. Inhale, drop the belly. Exhale, round through. Now keep it going on your own, and if you like, you can start to veer off the railroad tracks a little bit, finding what feels good, checking in with different parts of the body based on where you are today or where you are in your practice. And you can always just stay within the structure. But I say, like, especially if you're at home and, like, you're wearing whatever you want and you're in the comfort of your own space, I say get a little freaky. So you can start to check in with the shoulders, check in with the side body. Awesome, then reactivate that tabletop position. Once again, we're gonna curl the toes under or find our foundation, nice and strong. Inhale in, as you exhale, hovering table, lift the knees. Hug the low ribs in, breathe deep here, keep the neck nice and long. You're pressing away from the yoga mat, feeling this hollowing through the upper back body and this hollowing through the abdominal wall.
My arms.
You're here for 3. Find a softness in the jaw, 2, and on the 1, release. This time we're going to bring the big toes together, knees as wide as your mat. Inhale to drop the belly. Exhale, take it to the right. Round through. Come through extended child's pose. Side out a little bit here. Aww. And then keep the circle going as you take it to the left. And now come all the way forward once again. Now keep it going here. This beautiful circle opening up through the hips, the legs, the side body, the shoulder girdle, the neck, the palms, the forearms.
Okay.
Nice and awake, brighten your toes, keep the toes pressing down into the earth. When you feel ready, go ahead and reverse your circle. Reverse it. And then same thing here, you can kind of go a little freestyle here if you find a little catch and you want to work in the catch, go go for it. If you find, oh man, this extended child's pose just feels awesome, I'm gonna chill here while your drink is talking. Maybe a little wrist love might do the trick. All the while, remember, the breath comes first. Keep breathing.
My arms are sore.
Yes, this is you. Yeah.
Still moving and grooving. Let's meet back in extended child's pose. Hips melting back towards the heels. Don't worry if your extended child's pose doesn't look like mine. And if extended child's pose is not a great shape for you, then I recommend you just working here in a nice wide-legged knee position, but with the shoulders up. So hips up. All right. If the heart's melting down,
my knees keep cracking.
The palms bring them together. Walk the elbows. Heart a little more. Feel that stretch in the tricep and the shoulder as you take your little shark fin up and behind the neck, by the head. And then, if you're lifted here, if you're not back, let's just take a couple moments here to check in with the neck by bringing one ear to one shoulder. Fabulous. Take a big inhale. Exhale. Let's come all the way back up. You're going to keep
your hands. I can barely see. I don't know my glasses on. Can you breathe this way?
Left hand presses away from the earth.
My arm's starting.
The chest. You can imagine pulling a bow and arrow. Why does it have to be little? Let's say pulling a big bow and arrow all the way across the chest. And then reach up towards the sky. Again, integrate breath and movement. Marry them together.
Yay.
Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, come all the way through. Thread the needle, right fingertips underneath the bridge of the left arm. Great. Bring
wait,
right
what?
Hang on.
Around
through the left palm. I don't know if I can do that.
Exhale.
It actually feels really nice. I'm going to stay like this for a while.
Thank you.
I like this feeling.
Twist. Take one cycle of breath here.
Ooh, that's my favorite pose so far. No. Legit.
This is a different pose. Yeah. I was going to confuse it first, but now I'm getting it.
The knees wide as you exhale, thread the needle.
Thread the needle.
Soft and easy. Take a cycle of breath here. So
I can do this one.
Out. And then marrying the action to the breath. Breath
to the action. Oh, it does not feel good on my left side, but it feels great on my right side.
Exhale.
Yeah, my left arm's weird.
Threading the needle.
So confusing.
This feels wonderful. Yo, I should make yoga my daily thing. Thread the needle. This way, right? No, this way.
As you breathe out. Sweep and slowly come all the way back up. Great. Awesome. Walk the knees underneath you. You're going to cross one ankle over the other. Mindfully, you can use your palms to come all the way back through center and back to your nice, comfortable seat. Cool. Bring the left
that was leg fun.
Your center is in the right leg.
Yeah.
Slowly take our head and heart.
Wait, what are we doing?
Our right foot. You can spread your toes. Pull the yogi toes. Actively. Not going to get into too much detail here, but just a little bit to help you activate.
Oh, this is my feet.
Like, pull your right thigh bone, that right femur in. So just like we do a lot in our lunges.
Oh, this hurts the leg. I can't. This one hurts.
Oh, my foot.
Big breath, big stretch. Exhale as you take it over.
I can't reach my toe.
I can't
do it. Reach it.
I'm not flexible.
Neither am I.
I'm not flexible. I can't.
This hurts. This hurts so.
I can't even touch my ankles. This is embarrassing.
As far as I can get.
I can't. I can only barely move it past my knee. I cannot go down all the way like that.
Just a little energy. Go ahead and soften your head.
I can't even go.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna do this because this is all I can do.
Next.
Yeah, me too. I'm going as far as I can.
I can only do that when I bend my knee. That's all I can do.
Yeah.
Whether let it go, focus on the sensation, take this precious time.
Focus on the sensation.
Body's gonna be smiling after this.
Ew.
Alright, one more breath. Your right knee as generous as you need. Be kind to that left hand.
Oh, good. She's allowing us to bend our knees. Good, because I thought it was cheating.
Yeah, because I literally can't reach my toes.
I can't even.
I mean, I used to.
I'm flexible.
I think I was flexible back in middle school. I do remember touching my toes.
Oh, good. I'm more flexible on this side. See, I can actually do more on this side.
The left leg up long. Your leg's so tight, you're not alone here, that you're already kind of starting with this.
She's allowing us to bend our knees.
Love it. It's all good.
I can do that.
And feeling your best is kind of rewiring our thoughts and our language around how
we. My nose is itchy. I'm sorry if I'm sniffling a lot. Really bad allergies.
Plugging that left femur in, shifting gears so we can find that active leg. And when you're ready, inhale, left finger, both fingertips behind the ears. Sorry, you reach up. And then think up and over as we reach toward the left foot. And then feel free to experiment here, right? Like you're not stuck.
Feel free to experiment.
Breathe into your belly. See how this side's different from the other side.
This side's different. A lot different from the other side.
Yeah.
This hurts.
Yeah, I can't do it on my right. It's way worse on my right.
You have 6 minutes of this left.
And this is it. We're almost done. So listen to the sound of your breath.
Like four.
Your time spent on the mat. Pray any weary nerves or worries.
Oh, my leg! It hurts!
Oh,
inhale,
oh,
your springtime is often when we're shooting this and when it's coming out live. So we're going to end with a cobbler's pose or a butterfly. And bring the soles of the feet together. We're going to start with hands on the ankles here just so you can really drop down through, again, the femur, the thigh bone. And then in time, you can maybe take hands to the toes. You can use your thumbs to massage the arches. If you've never done that before, give it a go. See what happens.
Okay,
and then inhale, lifting up from the pelvic floor, finding this length from crown to tail. Once
again, this hurts.
That loving awareness to the spine.
Yeah, I can't keep my legs up.
Exhale, try to keep that length, so we're not going to round. You're going to keep that length as you bend your elbows, and you're going to send your gaze to look kind of in an imaginary pond. Just try to see your reflection.
The imaginary pond.
Joke, bad joke, but it's always like that moment in Zoolander when he's like looking in the puddle. And so give yourself that image. It's going to keep the spine nice and long. But also just kind of reflect back to you, remind you, even if it's in the silliest of ways, that, you know, this time is for you to be with yourself, to check in with yourself, take care of yourself. All right, maybe send your heart a little bit forward, a little more forward for this last breath. Taking stock. And then slowly release, bring it up. All right, send your hands behind you.
That hurts.
Your feet here.
That
hurts.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, I like this.
Side and then the other. take a couple cleansing breaths here, just a couple final I love you breaths as your windshield wiper the knees one way and the other. All right, feet come to the earth, elbows come down. I'm glad Benji's over there. Some of you have done this with me before. Last little boost. You're going to bring your feet to the ground and you're going to give your foot a little wake-up call. So you can start nice and small and then you can go crazy. If you're in an upstairs of an apartment or something, maybe be mindful. But if you're in a place where you can go crazy, I suggest you do for three, two, keep it going, and on the one, release.
Good thing I'm home alone, because everyone will be like, what the heck are you doing?
Twice more, just like that, big inhale. Empty it out. Last cleansing breath. Inhale, lots of love in. Exhale, lots of love out. Thanks, everyone. Let us know how this little ditty went for you in the comment section down below. Hope you're doing well.
All right, guys. That was our yoga. How was that?
If you guys thought it was boring, then sorry. That's what yoga is.
It's yoga. It's boring unless you're doing it unless you're doing it with us. That's fine. But you guys wanted to see that, so we showed it to you.
Yeah, and that was not comfortable for a few moves.
No, a lot of them are pretty comfy, but a lot of them also were not, so.
Yeah, if you're flexible, then probably are.
But me and Amy are not flexible.
No, not once. I think we used to when we were little, but not anymore.
Same. But yeah, so how do you feel after that, Amy?
Pretty sore, but also kind of comfortable in my arms, because, I mean, yeah. I think all that made my arms a little wake up.
Yeah, I'm feeling very loose. That actually feels kind of nice. So, I guess I'll end the stream here. Thank you guys for watching this, and I guess we will see you guys on Gaming Monday for part two of Granny.
So. Granny chapter 2, to be exact. And that's going to be just as creepy as the first one.
Yeah. So, I guess we will see you guys then. Bye!